Scout meeting.
Oh, I thought you had a Cub Scout meeting yesterday.
We did. This is an emergency meeting.
Emergency? What happened? Didn't you learn to tie your knots?
Yeah, we learned. Today we have to untie them.
On time?
We couldn't find any ropes, so we used Mr. Ramsey's neckties.
Hi,
Mommy.
Hi, sweetie pie.
Bye, Mommy.
Listen, before you go, what would the men of the house like for dinner tonight? I can't seem to think of anything different.
Oh, I don't care, honey. Just anything.
I don't care either.
Oh, you two are a big help.
All right, how about steak?
We had steak last night.
I like hot dogs.
Yeah, well, you had hot dogs night before last.
I like hot dogs every night.
You're telling me. Come on, Ricky, think of something, will you?
Honey, you decide. You can always come up with something good.
Oh, sure, I always come up with something good. I'm so sick of planning meals. Have you any idea how many meals I've cooked in the 18 years we've been married?
No. How many?
Well, now, let's see. 365 days a year, 3 meals a day. That's 15, 18, 19, 19, 1,095 times 18 years. 30, 17, 20, say, oh, 5, 6, 19,710 meals.
What about last Saturday night when we had dinner at the Ramses?
All right, 19,709 meals.
And what about all the times that we went out to restaurants or we were invited out to dinner?
So I got a few meals off for good behavior. Make it an even 19,000.
Good. That's exactly how many times you told me the same sad story.
Oh, well, I don't care. Being a housewife is a big bore. Cook the meals, do the dishes, make the beds, dust the house. Cook the meals, do the dishes, make the beds,
hey,
dust the house.
Hey, what do you know? It says here that Daddy Kay is going to London to give another command performance for Queen Elizabeth.
I wonder what the Quinn is cooking for Phil tonight.
Oh, listen to this. Paul Douglas is starting a new television show early in the morning next week.
Well, goody-goody. I can watch Paul Douglas while I cook the meals, do the dishes, make the bed.
All right, that's enough.
Maybe enough for you. I'm just getting warmed up.
Hi, Lucy.
Oh, hi, Ethel.
Hi.
Hi, Fred.
Well,
hi.
You ready to go to the market?
Ethel, what are you having for dinner tonight?
With my allowance, anything that's on sale.
Fred, what would you like for dinner?
Somebody else is cooking.
Come on, get your shopping bag and let's go.
Why not? Go to the market, cook the meals, do the dishes, make the bed.
What's eating her?
All you know is that popular record, The Housewife's Lament by Lucy Ricardo. I know all the lyrics. The last line goes just like this. For 2 cents, I go out and get myself a job.
Honestly, for 2 cents, I go out and get myself a job. I mean it. This time, I'm serious.
All right, go ahead. Go out, get yourself a job. Get it out of your system, once and for all.
What do you mean, get it out of my system?
Listen, girl, once you start working, you'll find out that it's just as humdrum and boring as being a housewife.
Nothing is as humdrum and boring as being a housewife.
Yeah. Besides, what makes you so sure you can even get a job?
I didn't have any trouble getting a job as a housewife.
Well, that was only because the boss was in love with you.
Oh, fiddle faddle.
You don't know how good you got it.
Oh, sure, I got it great.
Besides, if you've got a job, who's going to cook the meals, do the dishes, make the best, dust the house?
I'd hire a housekeeper.
A good housekeeper costs 40 or 50 bucks a week.
I know where you can get one for 25.
Where?
Oh, now, wait a minute. Why shouldn't I get 50?
That's for a good housekeeper.
Hey, that's a great idea.
What's a great idea?
You're being my housekeeper. It would be like found money. You could work here part-time and still take care of your own house.
Oh, now, just a minute.
Why not? You're over here most of the time anyway. Why not get paid for it?
Hey, I never thought of that.
Well, now, take your time. Think about it.
I'll take it.
Good.